At the heart of southern Europe, there's a place where wild things still roam. A pocket paradise of enormous contrasts, where nature's forces remain untamed, and raw beauty provides a home for rare beasts, where mountains soar above an island-studded sea, and forests overflow with life that plays out its drama on an ancient stage. Where time is healing recent wounds, but refuses to extinguish old traditions, and where life can find itself precariously balanced, but survives against the odds. It's time to discover the true colors of a country that can finally hold the world's attention for all the right reasons. This is Europe's best-kept secret. This is Wild Croatia. Croatia is a land of breathtaking beauty and extraordinary diversity. Lying spread-eagled across central southern Europe, its distinctive outline captures 8 national parks that cover nearly 1,000 square kilometers. Four and a half million people live mainly in the towns and cities, as life in the 21st century draws them away from their rural roots. The human communities left behind may be in decline, but others thrive on neglect. It's January, and winter holds the mountains of Plitvice under a spell. 600 meters above sea level, these highlands lie near the heart of Croatia, 200 kilometers from the coast. Sub-zero temperatures have made the last few months a time of slim pickings for many in the forest. But some are in their element. A Eurasian lynx. Shrugging off the cold, it limbers up for the evening's hunt. This is the largest species of lynx. Males can reach a meter in length and 35 kilograms. Broad paws covered in fur act as snowshoes. A formidable predator, they can take down prey 4 times their own size, and they only eat what they have killed themselves. The other forest inhabitants cannot afford to let down their guard. A roe deer would be a prime target for the lynx. In the winter, their broad diet lets them take advantage of whatever foliage still pokes through the snow. The females in this group may well be pregnant. Mating occurred 6 months ago, but pregnancy is delayed so that the birth coincides with the warmth of the following summer. For the inhabitants of Plitvice, the good times are on the way. By March, the sun finally gathers enough strength to break winter's icy grip. As the ice slips away, the meltwater starts its 1,000-kilometer journey to the Black Sea. From the mountains to the plains, via swollen streams to wide rivers, it surges through the landscape and brings it to life. The River Sava, a 940-kilometer tributary of the mighty River Danube, soon receives more water than it can handle and floods. The spring meadows along its banks are turned into one of Europe's largest wetlands, the Sava floodplains. Heaven on earth for wading animals. Of all descriptions. Horses were introduced here by the earliest Croat people. To cope with often harsh conditions, they bred their livestock to be tough, and the result was the rugged beauty of the Posavina horse. Indigenous to Croatia, Posavinas are known for their intelligence, stamina, and strength. Broad, flat hooves stop them sinking into the soft ground while they graze on the lush grasses. Their population is tiny but stable, a reminder of the harmony that can be achieved between man and nature. The wetlands are also grazed by more familiar, if less elegant, livestock. The cattle help keep the meadows open and the plant life diverse. If the horses and cattle are the wetlands' lawnmowers, the Turopolyi pigs are the hoovers. A cousin of the wild boar, this rare Croatian breed is hundreds of years old. Not fussy eaters, they root out anything edible, from acorns, roots and flowers to worms and insects. They can even dive for mussels. Competition from the modern domestic pig has left the Turopolyi facing extinction, but efforts are being made to restore their numbers. The pigs may be concentrating on their stomachs, but for others in the undergrowth, love is in the air. Fire-bellied toads use their bell-like calls to advertise for a mate. But some will act the slime ball with anything that hops. As this unfortunate frog finds out. The amorous amphibians must be careful, though. The orange mottling is a reminder to predators of their reputedly foul taste. But for some, a health warning on the packaging makes little difference. These wetlands are also home to one of Croatia's most iconic and graceful residents, the white stork. A springtime smorgasbord of amphibians and fish replenishes their energy following a migration from sub-Saharan Africa, where they spend the winter. Few small animals are safe from these pinpoint assassins. In Western mythology, storks are responsible for delivering infants to new parents. In the village of Sigoč, however, they are only concerned with the imminent arrival of their own offspring. Like many expectant parents, the first job is to renovate the nursery. Storks can form mating pairs for several seasons and return to the same nest year after year. Some nests have been in continuous use for centuries. Made of sticks, these towering eyries are masterpieces of avian engineering. Adult storks stand over a meter tall, with a 1.5 meter wingspan. To accommodate the family, the eyries can be 2 meters wide and 3 meters deep, all balanced up to 30 meters above the ground. The old hands make it look easy, most of the time. The males collect most of the materials, and the females prod them into place. Sigoč has more than 40 breeding pairs. Adult storks can barely vocalize, but bill clattering courtships make them noisy neighbors. There are also some uninvited guests, sparrows that make lively lodgers in the ground floor of the eyries. Many people have left Sigoč for new lives in the cities. But around 100 remain to keep the traditional way of life alive. With everything ready, The storks can breathe new life into the village for another year. Storks usually produce a brood of 3 to 5 chicks. But thanks to the abundance of food in the Sava wetlands, the Seagotch storks can raise 6. Soon there will be more storks in Seagotch than humans. Other outposts of life can be found along Croatia's unique coastline. More than 1,000 islands and reefs scattered across the deep blue waters of the Adriatic Sea. They vary in size from a single square kilometer to more than 400. Only 66 are inhabited by people. The islands and mainland have a combined coastline of almost 6,000 kilometers, more than twice that of South Africa. In the northern harbour town of Rovinje, people rely on the sea to make a living. Once an island itself, Rovinje is now part of the mainland, but still offers a remote sanctuary for people and wildlife. Croatia's southern coastal region, Dalmatia, is also a preserve of traditional livelihoods. This is the land of the shepherds. On Pag Island, almond blossom and crocuses add a splash of color to the craggy rocks that would otherwise look as barren as the surface of the moon. Hardy Pashki sheep are sustained by a thin layer of herbs and sage that gives their meat a unique flavor. But most are kept only for their milk, from which the island's speciality export is made, Pag's ewe cheese. Pag's 45,000 sheep supply the milk for 200 tons of cheese each year. It's churned by hand as it has been for centuries. The island air gives it a sharp, salty taste. A Croatian delicacy that is enjoyed around the world. By June, the coast of the mainland is transformed. Other residents of Dalmatia are busy with their own production lines. As the flowers bloom, an army of insects gets to work. They spread pollen as they drink their fill of the sugary nectar. A Dalmatian wall lizard takes no prisoners, but even he must be on his guard. This leopard rat snake would make short work of him. Said to be the most beautiful European snake, these constrictors reach a meter in length. The colorful jungle conceals a deadly game of hide and seek. By tasting the air with its tongue, the lizard can detect the snake from a distance, which it hopes will keep it one step ahead. Moving inland, the color of the coast is soon replaced by the harsh beauty of the Dinaric Alps. With peaks of 1,800 meters, this coastal mountain range runs the length of Croatia. The jagged slopes are home to one of nature's finest mountaineers, the chamois. These agile antelopes have flexible hooves that help them negotiate the mountainside at up to 50 kilometers per hour. The distinctive rock face is known as karst, meaning dry. Made of porous limestone and dolomite, it's dissolved by rainwater that reacts with carbon dioxide to form an acid. the gullies and outposts that remain have an otherworldly feel. The mountain peaks may look barren, but enough soil can be trapped in odd pockets to allow a few trees to cling on. On the lower slopes, Carniolan lilies find a refuge. Up to 5,000 millimeters of rain falls here each year. It's channeled into a few rare rivers with dramatic effect. At just 72 kilometers in length, the River Kirka does not so much flow to the Adriatic Sea as tumble. As it cuts through the Kirka National Park, it drops 220 meters over just 50 kilometers, cascading through 8 sets of rapids. Croatia is renowned for its breathtaking waterfalls, and those of Kirka are amongst the most spectacular. Further inland, away from the stark mountain peaks, forests flourish. Entering their cool, leafy depths is to step back in time to an age when forests retained their mystery and majesty. And there's no disputing the king of this realm. Croatia has around 1,000 brown bears. The maximum that its 10,000 square kilometers of forest can sustain. These two-year-old cubs are not yet serious predators, content to attack only roots and shoots, for now. But a cagey fox doesn't feel like taking any chances. Only a small proportion of a brown bear's diet may be meat, but that's of little comfort to a female red deer. An adult bear could be a significant threat to her own young. Female bears care for their cubs for up to 2.5 years, so the mother of these two delinquents won't be far behind. Like the bears, female deer also raise their young without any help from the males. The main protection is a coat flecked with gold that allows them to melt into the shadows. For a moment, curiosity on both sides prevails. Until the mother bear makes her presence felt. She's picked up the scent of the deer and spots them. Taking no chances, the deer retreat to safer ground. With her element of surprise gone, the bear does not give chase. There'll be better opportunities. The cubs regroup with their mother, and the deer can relax for now. In open areas, lush meadows are botanical treasure troves. Wild orchids are just one member of a colorful cast. It's no surprise that the vibrant flora has influenced the culture of the people and is reflected in their national dress. The Croats are both buoyant and resilient, and know the value of the natural riches of their country. The kolo is an old circular dance that remains an important feature of festivals today. The Croatian traditions are still very much alive. In the mountains of Plitvice, there is also reason to celebrate. In the warmth of summer, life is in full flow once again. This is the land of the falling lakes. Nested in the mountainside, 16 lakes are connected by a network of cascades and waterfalls. ...135 meters separates the highest from the lowest. The biggest waterfall stands 70 meters tall. Throughout Plitvice, streams bubble across the forest floor. But in this watery world lurks a creature once thought to be born of fire. The fire salamander was once feared by humans, who thought it a demonic and dangerous creature. Glands on its back do secrete toxic irritants that justify its bright orange warning colors. But their association with fire may be due to the habit of hibernating in rotting logs. When firewood warmed most people's homes, unlucky salamanders caught napping were thought to have mysteriously appeared from the flames. Their aquatic kingdom is shaped by a special stone, the travertine, a rock that can start life as a plant. Chalk dissolved in the water deposits on mosses and hardens to create new structures. Growing 1 centimeter a year, the barriers of this underwater world are constantly changing. Below the waterfalls, shoals of chub hang out. This is an introduced species that has flourished at the expense of the original populations of trout. The chalk gives the lakes a magical touch of turquoise. As it's washed away, below the surface of the forest, a new world opens up. In these huge caves, life is forever locked in darkness. The Olm is virtually blind. Eyesight is of little importance for an existence underground, as are skin pigments to protect against the sun's rays. This pale amphibian is only found in southern Europe's karst area. One of the planet's oldest species, it's a living fossil that was once considered the cub of a dragon, or even a human embryo. It can live for 50 years, and at 30 centimeters in length, is an unlikely looking top predator in these caves, wolfing down small invertebrates that it swallows whole. Before all of the chalk can seep away, some is recaptured in some of nature's finest sculptures. Stalactites drip from the roof of the caves, straining to touch fingertips with the stalagmites below. Above ground, the Plitvice skyline is dominated by forests that cover three quarters of this 300 square kilometer national park. Most are beech trees that provide fresh greens for the maybugs. After 3 years as a grub in the soil, the winged adults emerge to spend their last 6 weeks above ground, when they must mate and start the cycle once again. Brown bears also inhabit the forest of Plitvice. This time, a mother is keeping a more watchful eye on her offspring, that still wears the white collar of a bear baby. By copying its mother, the youngster learns essential survival skills. Nearby, an adolescent bear makes a tasty discovery: the carcass of a wild boar. The mother bear would have no qualms about claiming it for herself, and as resistance would be futile, the young upstart makes a dash to safety with his prize. To the northeast, in the Kopachik Yurt Reserve, parents also have their work cut out. In the swampy lowlands, where the Danube and Drava rivers meet, white swans are already breeding. The female incubates her eggs for 35 days and rarely leaves the nest. Close by, her mate keeps watch. He'll defend the nest against all comers if provoked. In the margins, other residents remain unruffled. European pond terrapins, happy to soak up some sun following a 7-month-long hibernation in the mud. Sunbathing's the only way to warm their blood, enabling them to hunt for small fish and invertebrates. But life in the slow lane may have its advantages. These reptiles can live for 50 years. Male broad-bodied chaser dragonflies lead a more ephemeral existence. In their brilliant birthday suits, they have just a few weeks of life to rush around and find a mate. High in the trees, male penduline tits are hoping that the females will come to them. But to attract them, they must first build the ideal home. The nests are not just for show. Made of reeds, they are so tightly woven that they are almost impossible for predators to tear apart. They've even been used as children's slippers. Suspended like teardrops, they are safely out of reach of potential nest raiders, grass snakes that hunt for amphibians in the shallows below. After 12 days of construction, the male must wait for a female to judge his handiwork. If it's up to scratch, she'll move in. In a loess wall near the Danube, male bee-eaters try to seduce the ladies with a different tactic: a dinner date. Courtship feeding can provide most of the energy a female needs to produce her eggs. The food of affection is a juicy bee, sting lovingly removed. But this tactic only works if you can resist eating it yourself. Close by, the bee eater's favorite snacks are hard at work. Honeybees have been reared in Croatia for hundreds of years. 80,000 bees may inhabit a single hive. One queen, several hundred male drones, and thousands upon thousands of sterile female workers make up the colony. The workers gather pollen and nectar that is converted into honey in the hive. They detect pollen-rich flowers using their keen sense of smell. But in Croatia, this is also being put to another use. Bees are being trained to detect the smell of explosives, to help locate some of the 250,000 landmines that contaminate 2% of the countryside. A deadly legacy of the Croatian War of Independence. If successful, honeybees could save many human lives each year. By July, the rewards of the Seagotch Stork's strong partnerships are making themselves heard. More than 140 storks now inhabit the rooftops. The parents both toil tirelessly for their brood. They bring thirst-quenching water. And for 2 months, ferry a conveyor belt of food from the wetlands to the nest. The spring floods have receded, but the meadows still offer rich pickings. The chicks can eat 60% of their body weight each day. They tap the parent's bill impatiently, encouraging it to regurgitate. Eventually, dinner is served. Some youngsters are already exercising their flight muscles. The soft down they were born with has been replaced by strong flight feathers. By September, they'll need to be accomplished flyers. Their winter feeding grounds in Africa lie 4,500 kilometers away. Those that survive will one day return to raise their own families and lift the spirits of Croatia once again. All across Sava, young families are being nurtured. Posavina foals are a welcome sight to Croatia's horse breeders, who each year try to increase their numbers. The reed beds are alive with activity, as wading birds nest in huge colonies. Rare Eurasian spoonbills and little egrets stand out in their white plumage, while the purple herons almost disappear against the backdrop. When the parents return to the nest, they're mobbed by hungry offspring demanding their share. More than 250 species of birds breed in Sava. That has become one of Europe's most important hotspots of biodiversity. Along the Adriatic coastline, the gulls are also flat out. Fattening up on a diet of seaside takeaways as fishermen return with their catch. Overfishing has reduced commercial stocks in the Adriatic. Each year, the fishermen find it a little harder to make a living. But the rocky coast is still home to a diverse marine community. There are 360 species of fish and 3 species of dolphin, including the playful bottlenose. Beneath the waves, an alien world opens up. Common octopus hunt mainly at dusk. Red scorpion fish bristle with venomous spines that can give a painful injury. Brightly coloured corals can even be found in these crystal clear waters. Along the shoreline, secret bays look like pockets of gold. The rugged slopes above the beaches are inaccessible to all but the most talented climbers. A four-lined tree snake slips from tree to tree, At 2.5 meters, this is Europe's largest snake. It hunts small mammals, birds, and lizards. But today is content to do some basking in a leafy oak. It's not the only resident of the coast taking advantage of the sun's powerful rays. As the warm air rises, the local hang gliding club rides the thermals. Eurasian griffins on the lookout for carrion. These members of the vulture family have 2.5 meter wingspans that can keep them airborne for 7 hours at a time. They may spend 2 days tracking a dying animal, only moving in once it's definitely dead. Ravens have reached this grisly scene first, but must make way when the professional undertakers arrive in force. Squabbles soon break out around the carcass. The short, smooth feathers on the griffin's face and neck allow it to rummage around for the choicest entrails, without getting clogged with gore. These opportunistic scavengers can gorge 5 kilograms of meat in a single sitting, but after such a belly buster, it may be an hour before they can take off again. Elsewhere on the coast, the focus is very much on the joys of life. In Croatia's southernmost corner lies the pearl of the Adriatic, the historic city of Dubrovnik. Its charming old town is a popular destination for the 10 million tourists who flock to Croatia each year. In the Croatian War of Independence, Dubrovnik was heavily shelled and seriously damaged. More than 12,000 people died in the conflict, and over 200,000 were displaced. The physical damage, at least, has largely been repaired, and a new generation can now look forward to a brighter future. In contrast to the hustle and bustle of the cities, the islands are sparsely populated. Their vineyards and olive groves, at first glance, appear tranquil and serene. But in the stony boundary walls lies a world within a world. Sharp-snouted rock lizards, threatened by shrinking habitat, find sanctuary here. But the crevices can conceal an unpleasant surprise. Balkan whip snakes that specialize in eating lizards. The ambush failed this time, but the whip snake knows that eventually its patience will pay off. By September, the summer is drawing to a close. The tourists leave, and the coasts are left in peace once again. In the chill autumn air, fog and frost give the Sava floodplains an enchanted feel. As the wetlands shrink to a few shallow pools, the local anglers gather expectantly. For all types of fishermen, a bonanza is about to begin. carp breeding has been an important industry in Croatia for over 100 years. More than 12,000 hectares of swamplands have been converted into fish ponds that produce 6,000 tons of carp and trout each year. The large reflective scales of the mirror carp make them easier to prepare for the table. The carp are weighed and sorted before being transported to market. In the wetland pools, the imprisoned fish stand little better chance of survival as herons and black storks methodically plunder the larder. Gangs of cormorants work together to corral the fish into corners where they can be more easily picked off. Herons hunt with deadly accuracy. A spoonbill sifts small animals and fish from the pool with their spatula-like beaks. Nothing will be left to waste. When one restaurant is empty, the greedy diners move on to the next. But table space is at a premium. Persistence pays off. The eerie crucifix-like stance is a cormorant trademark. The feathers are not waterproof, so the cormorant can lose buoyancy and become an agile underwater swimmer. After a hunt, the wings must be hung out to dry while the catch is digested. Overhead, other predators cast their own ominous shadows. But these young sea eagles are equally happy scavenging dead fish as they are catching their own. During the last century, sea eagles almost vanished from Europe, but have made a strong fight back, and today number around 10,000 pairs worldwide. Until they mature, these youngsters must make way for a regal cousin, the imperial eagle. Standing on the brink of extinction itself, there are only a few thousand of these rare raptors left. Just a handful of pairs breed in Croatia. Once a symbol of the Roman Empire, it remains to be seen whether this iconic bird of prey can win its own battle for survival. The ponds are soon nothing more than muddy troughs for the Turopoli pigs to have a final route through. After the summer excess, the sows have plenty of milk to fatten their piglets ahead of the winter. With a population of just 250, each one will be vital for the future of their breed. The Posavina horses provide unwitting models for this season's fashion. A headdress of burrs. These spiky seeds hitch a ride using a coat of tiny hooks, the natural version of Velcro. As the townsfolk prepare for the cold season, the livestock leaves the freedom of the open meadows for the winter. Along the coast, preparations are also being made to gather in the fruits of the summer's labour. In the Neretva Delta, tangerine trees planted between the network of channels are ripe for harvest. Of the 50,000 tons of tangerines produced here each year, almost three quarters are exported. They're considered some of the best in the world. Many fields can only be reached by true pitcher, a traditional type of boat only found in this region. The waters may be calm now, but a storm is coming. Along the coast, dark clouds gather, forebearers of the Bora, one of the world's strongest winds. November is the start of the peak Bora season. When low and high pressure air masses collide over the Dinaric Alps, cold continental air is forced down the mountainsides at up to 200 kilometers per hour. When the Bora strikes, the Adriatic is churned into a cauldron. The Bora can last for 5 days and produce gale force winds for 12 hours at a time. Some coastal towns have narrow streets to limit the power of the wind that can knock down people and overturn cars. For all residents of the coast, the best option is to lie low and wait for the storm to pass. Away from the violence at the coast, the mountains of Plitvice appear an oasis of calm, although danger still lurks in the forest. Tufts on the lynx's ears may enhance hearing, magnifying the rustlings of small mammals in the undergrowth. Once extinct in Croatia, Europe's only big cat now number around 60 here. Now protected from hunting, the hope is that they're back for good. The land of the falling lakes is now full of falling leaves as deciduous trees begin to bear all for winter. The brown bears are also getting ready for the cold snap. Gorging themselves around the clock, they eat up to 40 kilograms of food every day. They'll spend the winter hibernating in underground dens and will lose up to half their body weight. The females may give birth in the dens, but only if they have sufficient reserves to ensure their own survival. The autumn binge is essential for themselves and the next generation. Finally, the deep freeze returns, and the pace of life slows again. The red deer stags develop a thick brown coat and mane to see them through the winter. Their bone antlers can reach 1.5 meters in length. At the end of the winter, they'll be shed to make way for a new set, larger and more branched than the last, to further increase their prowess the following season. As the temperature reaches zero, the waterfalls of Plitvice struggle to keep flowing. By December, the lakes will be frozen. As the land falls into an icy slumber, the wild inhabitants must wait patiently. In just a few months, this unique corner of our planet will be unlocked to overflow with life once again. Croatia's people are enjoying a new beginning, while its wildlife thrives thanks to the customs of the past. As the world now falls under its spell, its natural riches must be respected and preserved. Left in peace, its oldest inhabitants will continue to embody the spirit of a magical place. A spirit wild and free.